بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. We have a young patient, 23 years old, who presented with the history of severe low back pain radiating to right leg. We have T2 weighted sagittal sequences and T2 weighted axial sequences as well. Here we can see normal height and hydration patterns of upper four lumbar discs, while there is reduction in normal hydration of L5-S1 disc. That is why it shows reduced signals on sagittal T2 weighted image, and we can confirm these things on axial T2 weighted sequence. This one is L5-S1 disc, and we see that nucleus pulposus, which usually present increased signals on axial T2 weighted sequence, shows reduced signals in this disc. Here we have normal endless fibrosis, and this is normal bright nucleus pulposus. This one is the disc, another disc. You can see endless fibrosis and nucleus pulposus, and these are end plate levels. Here we can see there is posterior indentation of annulus fibrosis. This is a normal presentation of posterior aspect of the disc. And there is moderately large disc protrusion from right posterolateral aspect of L5-S1 disc, which is abnormal. This is thecal sac, which is compressed from right side. And here we can see this is left lateral canal and left exiting neural foramen. On right side, we can see right lateral canal is completely obliterated by the disc, including part of right exiting neural foramen at this level. This can be confirmed on sagittal images. This is right paracentral disc protrusion. We can see tightening of inferior recess of right exiting neural foramen. So this patient shows normal lower dorsal card and conus, while lumbosacral vertebrae shows normal height with intact end plates. There is normal alignment of lumbar vertebrae. No evidence of discovertebral osteomyelitis. So in this case, as patient clinically presents right-sided sciatica, we have seen moderately large sized right paracentral disc protrusion causing severe right lateral canal narrowing and significant narrowing of inferior recess of right exiting neural foramen, while remaining lumbar discs are unremarkable with capacious bony canal and thecal sac at the respective level. So today's example was about soft compressive disc disease and radiating pain toward legs. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.